على محمد وآل محمد.
Knowing that the time is near, the time is near.
Brother, don't you hear the uproar of the enemy's army reaching near?
Just now, I saw the holy prophet in a dream. He told me I was coming to him.
How sad is this for me?
Sister, don't be sad. Be calm. Allah is with you.
My master, the enemy has reached. What is to be done?
Oh, my brother Abbas, may my life be sacrificed for you. Mount your horse and go ask him why they have launched attack at this time, but no progress has taken place.
Oh people, what is the reason for your sudden attack?
We have just received orders from our emir that either you should surrender or we should launch an attack immediately.
Do not take any hasty step until I give your message and get the reply from Imam Hussein.
My master, they are demanding you to surrender or they will surely attack.
Go back to them and ask them for more time until tomorrow, so we may all offer prayers to Allah and seek His forgiveness. Allah knows that I love to offer prayers, recite the Quran, and ask for His forgiveness.
It is the final night for the army of Hussein. It is the final night for Abbas, Qasim, Akbar, and Zuhair bin Kain. The final night for the leaves of Hussein's family tree. The final night the women and children will be adorned with these jewels of safety. It is the final night.
I'm thankful for all your affection and willingness to help me at this hour. But I assure you, Yazid is only thirsty for my blood. I hereby discharge you of your obligation under your pledge of allegiance to me, and release you of all bonds you have pledged to assist me. I like that you have me now, but go back to your homes. I will not hold you responsible if you go away now, as it is not wajib for you to stay. If you feel shy to leave before my eyes, I will close the lights, so in the darkness, no one can see who left the camp.
Hold to the life without you!
If we were to be killed 1,000 times, and then we would be revived, we would still be fighting the oppressor and to protect the just cause of our Imam.
I am proud to have such companions. Neither the prophets of before, nor my grandfather, nor my father has had as many devoted companions as I do now at this time of adversity.
Hur was not only his name, but his reality. Like a bird, he was destined to be free. Yet even as he was a victim of the enemy's puppetry, he was able to feel what others could not see. And to and fro he paced. To and fro he paced the night before the treacherous day. But it was not the pacing of the limbs, but the pacing of his heart, that from the enemy he broke away, like a fallen leaf that changes colors. Away he flew. With the army of Allah did he stand true. For the message of Islam did he fall for the truth, free in this world and free in the next. Hur was not only his name, but his destiny.
Son, lay down all arms. My master, please forgive me for my unforgivable sins.
I am pleased with you, and the Lord, your creator, is also pleased with you.
My mom, please allow me and my son to go and lay our life for you.
Hur, you are my guest. How will I let you die for me?
Please, my master, allow me to lay my life for you.
Your mother named you well. Hur, free in this world and free in the next.
My son, tomorrow there will be a battle. I cannot ask you to fight because you are too young. But if anything happens to Imam Hussein and you are still alive, I will be filled with shame.
Mother, we have the blood of Ali and Jafar in our veins. Our grandfathers were warriors whose fame will always be remembered. Do you think we can possibly shame them? Moreover, we are the pupils of Uncle Abbas.
Mother, unless you forbid us and stop us from fighting, we shall go to the battlefield and show the enemy how bravely the children of Islam can fight. All we want from you is a promise that you will never weep for us. Our souls will never rest in peace if you grieve for us after we are gone.
Hussein, at the Battle of 15, Hazrat Abbas was only 8 years old. He saw someone trying to attack you. He rushed into the battlefield and killed the man. Do you remember how proud our father Ali was? I too want to be proud of my son. I want to see them go out and defend Islam. Will you not allow me that privilege?
Go and show the world how those as young as you can fight against the injustice and oppression of Yazid.
Be aman Allah, mother.
Bismillah, my son. May Allah be with you. Ya Allah, I thank you for accepting my sacrifice. My heart is filled with pride because my two sons have given their lives for your religion.
Hussein's nephew, Hassan's pride and joy await so anxiously, thinking if only. If only his uncle would give him permission. If only his uncle would see his submission. If only his father was alive today, would he have his chance to be slain. If only his father was alive today, would his mother share his pride and joy. If only his father was alive today, would someone aid in cherishing the pieces of Qasim's body in the above Hussein? If only.
Mother, tomorrow Uncle Abbas, Ali Akbar, and I will defend Imam Hussein. Mother, if I die, please do not weep for me.
My son, although I love you dearly, I shall not weep for you. Nothing would make me prouder than to see my son give his life for Islam.
My uncle, please give me permission to go and fight for you.
My son, you're very young, and your mother's only son. I cannot let you go and fight.
My son, your father said if you live in a time of difficulty, to give you this letter.
My son, a day will come when my brother Hussein will be facing an enemy army of tens of thousands. That will be the day when Islam will need to be saved by sacrifice. You must represent me on that day. My uncle, a letter from my father.
Oh, my brother's son, How can I stop you from doing what your father had wanted you to do? Bismillah. Go, may Allah be with you. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un.
Oh my uncle, do not be upset. I do not fear death. Death to me for Islam will be sweeter than honey.
The sacrifice of Abbas is truly one from cradle to grave, one that each part of him can testify how worthy he proved as Allah's slave. From the windows of his soul, his eyes, once filled with tears of worship, now brimmed with blood. The heart, once erupting with Sakina's love, now pierced in regret as a puddle of mud. And the arms, once lifted in prayer to Allah, now lay on the barren land of Karbala. But most of all, it's his mouth that proved his submission as no other. Once declaring Hussein as his Mola, now utters his last salam to his brother.
My master, please allow me to go and fight for you.
Abbas, you're the captain of my army. You're my alamdar. I cannot let you go and fight.
I'm thirsty, my uncle Abbas.
My master, please allow me to bring water for the children who are crying of thirst.
Okay, my brother. Bring the children water to quench their thirst.
My master, I have come to say goodbye.
My brother, come embrace me. My brother, I want a gift from you. I want your sword.
O water of Furat, my lips can only welcome you only after Sakina has quenched your thirst.
Do not let that water reach Hussein's camp, otherwise we will all be doomed.
Ya Allah, do not let them kill my uncle Abbas. I'll never ask for water again.
Mawlai, why did you take the time to come here? You should be looking after Sakina.
My brother, all your life you have served me and my children. Is there anything I can do for you in the last moments of your life?
Akha, when I was born, I first looked at your face. Please wipe the blood off my eyes so I can see your beloved face again. Mawlai, please do not take my body back to the camp. I did not wish for Sakina to see me in this state.
My brother, I too have a wish to be fulfilled. All your life, you have called me master. Just once, call me brother before your last breath.
My brother, my Imam.
With the birth of a son, a father dreams of his child's future, his many destinies. But what was of Hussein's dreams? Surely, it could not have been the nightmare he had seen. Had he dreamt of allowing Akbar to fight, knowing that he would lose his life? Did he dream of following his son to the battlefield, longing to be his protection, his shield? Was it part of Hussein's dream to think, to be unable to quench his Akbar's thirst with a drink? Did he dream running on the land of Karbala, yelling Inna Ali in Nineveh? But I wonder most, of all the scenes, was it Hussein who dreamed of ripping any dream or aspiration apart, tearing an arrow from Akbar's heart?
Oh, Akbar, you have my permission. May Allah be with you. But Akbar, you know how much your mother, your aunt, and your sisters love you? Go and say farewell to them.
Oh, Akbar, how can we live without you?
Assalamu alaikum. My father, my last salam to you.
Abbas, not that this brother needs you the most. Where have you gone? Upper, why do you only embrace me with one hand? Father, I have too come to my khabar.
Every man who stood with Hussein last night, today lay slain after their brave fight. Alone Hussein was to defend the truth. Alone Hussein was with no man to turn to. Wait, Baba, I am still alive. Wield Asghar through his thirsty cries. But little did Rubab know, as she gave her heart away to go, the Asghar she prayed would defend Islam one day, honored his faith in the most brutal way. So much that the mighty Hussein wavered back and forth, witnessing a mother's pain. Asghar's cries were heard no more, but her baby's cry is what Rubab now longs for.
Rubab, let me take him to Yazid's army. Surely they cannot deny a few drops of water. Oh people, this child has done no harm to you, and it is dying of thirst. Is there anyone to provide a few drops of water to this child?
Beware, my soldiers. Do not be lured by Hussein's word. He is only tricking you into getting some water for himself. Even if Hussein gets only one sip, it will strengthen him, and several of us will lose our lives.
If you're afraid that I'll drink the water, then here, I'll put him on the floor, so you may quench his thirst. Asghar, my son, show them how thirsty you are! Rubab, this is a test from Allah that no mother was ever subjected to go through. Come with me, and we'll make a grave for Amas and myself.
With all his men slain, in Asghar's blood on his hands, alone Hussein stands, alone, so very alone. As Zain al-Abidin embraces his father and says goodbye, he must now defend Islam alone, so very alone. As Zainab helps her brother mount his horse one final time, she is left to protect the women and children alone, so very alone. As Sakina sleeps upon the chest of her father one last time, she will now sleep alone, so very alone. But it is the warrior of Allah who had brought back all the fallen souls that now lays upon a bed of arrows in Karbala alone, so very alone.
Abbas, I'm so alone, so very alone.
Father, why are you alone? Where's Uncle Abbas? Where's on the Akbar, where's Qasim? We're all your companions.
My son, no man except you are alive. You or I is left alive. They've all gave their life for Islam. My son, where are you going?
To fight Yazid's army.
No, my son. You're too ill for jihad. I've come to say farewell. look after the ladies and the children of the camp. And when you go back to Medina, my son, give my love to Sugra and tell her in the last moments of my life, I wish I could have given her a hug before I got killed. And my son, give my salams to your friends and tell them to think of me whenever they drink cold water. O Zainab, O Kulthum, O Sakina, O Rukaya, O Rubab, O Fizza, my greetings to you. Farewell to you all.
Oh, do not take my father away from me. Do not let them make me a female.
Sakina, you're the great-granddaughter of the Holy Prophet. I love you so much that if you say not to go, I will not go. But Islam will be destroyed. How will you or I be able to face the Holy Prophet on the Day of Judgment?
Bismillah, Father.
Is there anyone to help us? For those of you who do not know me, I'm the grandson of the Holy Prophet. I'm the path of truth. Yazid personifies falsehood and corruption. He's leading you away from Islam. Do not follow him. Do not kill the grandson of the Messenger of Allah. Allah will never forgive you.
Do not fall victims to the saint's oratory. Kill him.
If you're determined to fight me, then fight you I shall. I do not fear death. Death is sweeter to me than dishonor. Now you all shall see the valor of the son of Ali ibn Abu Talib.
Oh, Yes, I am.
Can you please show me the way to Najaf?
Why would you want to go to Najaf at this hour and at this date?
I want to complain to my grandfather, Ali ibn Abu Talib, about how they killed my father.
Oh, son! All our men have been killed. Our tents have been set on fire and our headscarves have been snatched. We have no option but to remain in these tents and be burnt to ashes or go out into the open. You are the Imam succeeding our martyred Lord Hussein. What do you order us to do in the present state of affairs?
My aunt, it's compulsory to save our lives. Gather everyone from the burning tents and take them out to the open.
السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله السلام عليك يا ابن رسول الله السلام عليك يا ابن أمير المؤمنين وابن سيد الوصيين السلام عليك يا ابن فاطمة سيدة نساء العالمين السلام عليك يا نصار الله وابن نصاره والوتر المفتون السلام عليك وعلى الأرواح التي خلت دفنائك عليكم مني جميعا سلام الله أبدا ما بنيت وبنيت مضي الليل والنهار يا أبا عبد الله لقد عظمت الرزية وجلت عظمة المصيبة بك علينا وعلى جميع أهل الإسلام وجلت عظمة مصيبتك في السماوات على جميع أهل السماوات فلعن الله أمة أسست أساس الظلم والجهل عليكم أهل البيت ولعن الله أمة دفعتكم عن مقامكم وأزالتكم عن مراتبكم التي رتبكم الله فيها ولعن الله أمة قتلتكم ولعن الله الممهدين لهم بالتمكين من قتالكم
Today, the woman will finally be free of these barren lands of Karbala. As they climb up a new mountain of calamity and create a new meaning of tragedy. Leaving behind a once desolate land, now fertile with Hussein's family tree. Today, Karbala is where these women long to be.
O people of Kufa, do not have any sense of shame before Allah and his messenger, so you look upon the ladies of the Prophet? All praise is due to Allah. Peace and blessings be upon my father Muhammad and his good and righteous progeny. May the resounding of this calamity never stop. Your similitude is one who unspins what is already spun out of the desire to violate a trust. You make religion a source of your income. Truly bad is that which you souls have committed. You have reaped the wrath of Allah, remaining in chastisement for eternity. Do you really cry and sob? By Allah, you shall then cry a great deal and laugh very little, for you have earned nothing but shame and infamy, and you shall never be able to wash it away. For how could you do so? The descendant of the bearer of the last message, the very essence of righteous from among you, the one who saves you from calamity, the master of the youth of paradise is killed. Woe unto you, O Kufans! Do you know whose heart you have burned? What a feat you've labored? Whose blood you've shed and what a sanctity you've violated? You've done a most monstrous deed, something for which the heavens are to split asunder, and so is the earth, and for which the mountains crumble. You've done something most uncanny, most defaced, as much as the fill of the earth and of the skies. Do you wonder why the sky rains blood? Surely the torment of the hereafter is a greater chastisement, and they shall not be helped. Let no respite await you, for rushing does not speed it up, nor does it fear the loss of the opportunity of revenge. Your Lord is waiting in ambush for you.
O people, whoever recognizes me knows me, and whoever does not, let me tell them that I am Ali's son of Hussein. I am the son of the one whose sanctity has been violated, whose wealth has been plundered, and whose children have been seized. I am the son of the one who was killed by the Euphrates, neither out of blood revenge nor on account of an inheritance. I am the son of the one who was killed at Karbala. I am, and this suffices me to be proud. O people, I plead to you, do you not know that you wrote to my father, then deceived him? Did you not grant him your covenant, your promise, and your allegiance? Then you fought him. May you be ruined for what you have committed against your own souls and through your corrupt views. Through what eyes will you look at the messenger of Allah when he says, you killed my progeny and violated my sanctity, so you do not belong to my nation?
You have perished, yet you're not aware of it.
You have perished, yet you are not aware of it. Then he, peace be with them, said, may Allah have mercy on anyone who acts upon my advice and who safeguards my legacy with regard to Allah. For we have, in the Messenger of Allah, a good example of conduct to emulate.
We, O son of the Messenger of Allah, hear and we obey, and we shall safeguard your trust. We shall not disobey you, and we shall fight when you fight. We shall seek us, and we will seek asylum when you do so. May Allah have mercy on you, for we disassociate ourselves with whoever oppressed you and dealt unjustly with you.
Far, far away is it for you to do so. O people of treachery and conniving, do you want to come to me as you did to my father? No, but the Lord of all those who ascend and descend. The wound is yet to heal. My father and his Ahlul Bayt were only killed yesterday, and the loss that inflicted upon the messenger and my family is yet to be forgotten. Its pain by Allah is between both of these. Its bitterness is in my throat and palate, and his choke is resting in my very chest.
Praise be to Allah, who exposed you to shame, who killed you and proved you liars.
Praise be to Allah, who honored us by choosing Muhammad as his prophet and purified us with the perfect purification. Rather, only a debauchee is exposed to shame, and a sinner is proven to be a liar, and we are neither.
How have you seen what Allah has done to your Ahlul Bayt?
I have seen him treating them most beautifully. These are the people Allah prescribed martyrdom, and they leap from their beds welcoming it. And Allah shall gather you and them, and he shall question you, and your opponents shall charge you. So you will then see whose lot shall be in the crack of hell. May your mother, O son of Marjana, lose you.
Allah has healed my heart by letting me seek revenge on your tyrant and his rebels and mutineers amongst his Ahlul Bayt.
By my life, you have killed my middle-aged protector, persecuted my family, cut off my branches and pulled out my roots. If all of this heals you, then you are indeed healed.
And who are you?
I am Ali's son of Hussein.
Did not Allah kill Ali?
I used to have a brother, also named Ali, who people have killed.
It was Allah who killed your brother.
Allah takes the souls of people's lives at the time of their death. No one dies without Allah's permission.
Kill him!
O Ibn Ziyad, suffices you what you have shed of our blood? Have you really spared anyone other than this? If you want to kill him, kill me with him as well.
Do you not know that we are used to being killed? Martyrdom is one of the blessings Allah has sent upon us.
Leave him for her. Amazing is her tie of kinship. She wishes to die with him.
Broken and weary, Zainab and Ali's courage has not exhausted. As they stand before the beast of all evils, they combat him with their words and shield with the truth. For little does Yazid know. He may have slaughtered Hussein, but his blood still remains. He may have massacred the innocent, but Islam still remains. He may have chopped down a family tree, but the roots will forever remain.
How did you, Ali, see what Allah did to your father Hussein?
I saw what Allah, the one and only Allah, the most exalted one, had decreed before creating the heavens and the earth. Do you permit me to ascend this pulpit to please Allah Almighty and bring good rewards for these people?
Yes, provide you not utter verbal attacks. Indeed not.
Let him speak. What can he say now?
These are the people who have inherited knowledge and oratory.
Let him speak. What harm can his words cause?
All praise is due to Allah, for whom there is no beginning, the everlasting, for whom there is no end, the first, for whom there is no starting point, the last, for whom there is no ending point, the one who remains after all beings no longer exist. He measured the nights and the days, and he divided them into parts. So blessed is Allah, the King, the All-Knowing. O people, I am the son of Makkah and Mina. I am the son of Zamzam and As-Safa. I am the son of the one who carried the rukun on his mantle. I am the son of the best man who ever put on clothes and made tawaf and say, of whoever offered hajj and pronounced the talbiyah. I am the son of the one who was transported on the Burak and was taken by Jibrail to Siddat al-Muntaha to be closer to his Lord as a throw of a bow, or closer still. I am the son of the one who led the angels in the heavens in prayers. I am the son to whom the Mighty One revealed what he revealed. I am the son of the defender of the messenger at Badr and Hunayn, and never disbelieved in Allah, not even as much as the twinkling of an eye. I am the son of the best of the believers, and the heir of the prophets, and the leader of the Muslims, and the killer of and those who offer jihad, and the killer of the renegades, and those who deviated from the straight path, and those who scattered the Ashab, and the most courageous one, the one with the firmest determination, Al-Hassan, the father of the grandson of the Prophet, Al-Hassan and Al-Hussein. Such is Ali ibn Abi Talib. I am the son of Fatima al-Zahra, the head of all women. I am the son of Khadija al-Kubra. I am the son of the one whose blood the sand mixed. I am the son of the one who was killed at Karbala. I am the son for whom the jinns wept in the dark and the birds in the air cried.
Start the azam.
Allahu Akbar.
Allah is greater, more kind, and more magnanimous than anything of what I fear and what I avoid.
Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah.
Yes, I testify with everyone that testifies there is no Allah besides Him, nor any other Lord.
Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah.
I ask you by Muhammad to stop here till I speak to this man. This great messenger of Allah, is he my grandfather or yours? If you say he is yours, then everyone present here and others will know that you are a liar. And if you say he is mine, then why did you kill my father unjustly and oppressively and plundered his wealth and kept his woman captive? Woe unto you on the day of judgment when my grandfather will be your opponent.
Start the prayers.
The nightingale's once beautiful melody, now deafened by the weight of tragedy. Imprisoned behind the walls of solitary, with no one left to sing for, the nightingale's song is heard no more.
Father in a dream.
Take the head of our father to keep her quiet.
Oh, man. Sallu ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. May I request all the sisters to proceed to hall B and C, and inshallah we'll have Matam now. Please turn on the lights, somebody. Matam Hussain. Ya Hussain.